guitar gently weeps. I look at the floor and I see it needs sweeping. Still my guitar gently weeps. I don't know.
Hello, I'm Eric Wheat, and I want to thank you very much for joining me in my wine and spirit studies. In this video, I'll be doing a review of the Hakushu single malt Japanese whiskey, aged 12 years. In the opening shots you saw there at the beginning of the video, those were taken on July 6, 2017, on my 51st birthday, and that is the Hakone Japanese Park in Saratoga. There are four Japanese gardens here in San Francisco Bay Area. And so I've been doing photography for the videos for the Japanese whiskey reviews at the various garden. The first one was in episode 52, at the Hibiki Suntory Japanese whiskey. And that was photographed at the Hayward Japanese Park. I used to live just like 5-minute walk right around the corner from there. In episode 106, I did the Nika Pure Malt Japanese whiskey, and I did the photography for that at the Japanese Friendship Garden in San Jose. And then in episode 152, I did the photography of the Iwai Tradition Japanese whiskey, and that was photographed at the Japanese Tea Garden in Golden Gate Park in San Francisco. So of all these Japanese gardens here in the San Francisco Bay Area, I would say the most beautiful is probably the Japanese Tea Garden in Golden Gate Park. But it also gets the heaviest tourist traffic there, so it can be a little crowded. So my favorite is actually the one that was right around the corner from where I used to live. I mean, I could literally walk there from my house in 5 minutes, and that is the Hayward Japanese Garden. It's small but extremely well manicured, really well kept, and it has a koi pond, a little bridge, and stuff like that. Japanese garden in San Jose, the Japanese Friendship Garden, is a fairly large. It's free to get into, but you got to pay for parking. And then the Hakone Park, Japanese park, where I did photography for this video, is really, really nice as well. So I've been really looking forward to doing this review. As I said, did the photography on my birthday, July 6th, on really warm weather. Not exactly whiskey drinking weather, so I've been waiting till it got a little colder, and this week we're probably in the 60s and we're getting some rain, so it's good whiskey drinking weather. All right, but before I get into this whiskey, here are my notes on the distinctives of Japanese whiskey as well as history. Whiskey production in Japan began around 1870. But it was not until 1924 that the first commercial distillery was opened, Yamazaki. Two of the most influential persons in the history of Japanese whiskey are Shinjiro Tori and Masataka Takatsuru. Shinjiro Tori was a pharmaceutical wholesaler and the founder of Kurobukiya, later to become Suntory. He started importing Western liquor and later created a brand called Akadama Port Wine, based on a Portuguese wine, which made him a successful merchant. He then decided to build the first Japanese whiskey distillery in Yamazaki, a suburb of Kyoto, which is known for excellent water and is home to the tea room of the legendary tea master Sen no Rikyu. Tori hired Masataka Takatsuru as a distillery executive. In the 1920s, Takatsuru had studied the art of distilling in Scotland. Whilst working for Kurobukiya, or Suntory, he played a key part in helping Tori establish the Yamazaki Distillery. In 1934, he left Kurobukiya to form his own company, Ene Pokanokuyu, which would later change its name to
Nika, which is a lot easier to pronounce. In this venture, he established the Yochi Distillery in Hokkaido. Japanese whiskey production, similarities and differences with Scotch whiskey. The Japanese method of producing whiskey is modeled after Scotch whiskey. Masataka Takatsuru studied the process of making whiskey in Scotland and sought to recreate that process in Japan. The location of Yochi in Hokkaido was chosen particularly for its terrain and climate, which are in many ways reminiscent of Scotland. However, for economic reasons, the first distillery actually was built in the more convenient location of Yamazaki on the main island. All barley and peat is imported from Scotland. Malted barley is distilled in pot stills to make single malt. Like Scotland, corn, wheat, and malted barley is distilled in column and coffee stills to produce grain whiskey. However, Japan has developed a whiskey style that reflects their own culture. In Scotland, whiskey is made from either with a cloudy wort, with husk fragments present, or clear wort, no husk remaining, which has been fermented for a long time with a selection of yeasts. Japanese whiskey producers almost always use a clear wort, which gives a clean, precise array of flavors and rarely any maltiness. Another difference between Japanese and Scotch whiskey is the way that Japanese blended whiskey is produced. In Scotland, distilleries sell or trade the new make spirit with other producers, which are then blended and aged in barrel in order to create a particular profile. The Scotch blended whiskies contain components that may involve malt whiskey from a number of distilleries, and each of these could conceivably be owned by a different company. In contrast, Japanese producers do not sell or trade their whiskies in order to create a blended whiskey. Rather, the same Japanese whiskey company will own both the distilleries and the brands of blended whiskies. In fact, these companies are often reluctant to trade with their competitors. So a blended whiskey in Japan will generally only contain malt whiskey from distilleries owned by that same company, or they may be supplemented with malts imported from Scotch distilleries. This is not to say that Japanese whiskies are monolithic. They use a range of different shaped and sized stills and use a variety of wood treatments, including sherry, imported American bourbon casks, and local Japanese Mizunera oak barrels. Japanese whiskey distillers produce a wide range of profiles, including light, delicate styles reminiscent of Speyside, smoky and peaty styles of Islay, as well as heavily sherried whiskies. Japanese whiskey producers. The most well-known and widely distributed Japanese whiskey producers are Suntory and Nika. Both distilleries produce blended whiskies, single malt whiskies, and blended malt whiskies. Their main blended whiskies are Suntory Kakubin, which means square bottle, and Black Nika Clear. They also produce a wide variety of special bottles and limited editions. Japanese distilleries. As of 2011, when the Shinshu Distillery reopened, there are around 9 active whiskey distilleries in Japan, which are as follows. Yamazaki, which is owned by Suntory, is located between Osaka and Kyoto on the main island of Honshu. Hakushu, which is also owned by Suntory, is located in the Yamanashi Prefecture on the main island of Honshu. Yoichi, which is owned by Nika, is located on the north on the main island near the city of Sendai. Miyagikyo is owned by Nika, and it is located at the foot of Mount Fuji in Shizuoka. Fuji Gotemba is owned by Kirin, and it is located near Chinchibu in Saitama Prefecture. Chichibu is owned by Ichiro Akuto, and it is located in Nagano Prefecture on the main island of Honshu. Shinshu is owned by Hombo, and it is located in Nagano Prefecture on the mainland of Honshu. And White Oak is owned by Aigashima Shuzo, which is located in Hyogo on the main island of Honshu. Hakushu 12-year-old single malt Japanese whiskey. Suntory's Hakushu, known as the Forest Distillery, was built in 1973 as a sister distillery to Suntory's Yamazaki Distillery. The facility is located at a high elevation site next to the pristine waters of the Ojira River, which are used in the whiskey production. Hakushu Distillery uses different styles of oak barrel to age their single malt, but mainly hogshead, which, according to the distillery, is suitable to the clear air and cool, humid climate. The 12-year-old from Hakushu is lightly peated and is very delicate in its flavor profile.
Alrighty, let's get into it. So, this whiskey has some coloring in it, so it doesn't do a whole lot of good to comment on the coloring other than I recently did a blind tasting and I had bourbon right next to a Calvados. And the bourbon is not allowed to be colored. Calvados might be colored, and they were practically the same color. I visually couldn't tell the difference between the two. Anyhow, on the nose, medium intense aromas of... Now, this is supposed to be a peated whiskey. So when I bought this and had read that it was a peated whiskey, you know, you're expecting something, maybe trying to get close to something from Islay, but nope. It's just barely there. I would say this even has less smokiness than a Johnny Walker Black. A lot of fresh fruit notes. Peach, pear, little orange. So I got a little citrus. A lot of honey notes. Maybe some yellow apple. A little bit of caramel, a lot of vanilla. And just the faintest amount of smoke. So if you're thinking this is a Japanese attempt to imitate Islay or even a peated whiskey from the Northern Highlands, it's nowhere near that. All right, on the palate. One more. Really, really nice. It has some sweetness to it. It's definitely a rich, very, very, very rich, sweet, luscious whiskey. Got those sort of maybe canned peaches, yellow apple, pear, some citrus, some orange and some lemon, and then transitions into sort of a little bit of caramel, toffee, and a lot of vanilla, and just the most minute amount of smoke. That I think just sort of acts almost as if like it's a spice in a way, because it's just a faint hint of smoke. On the back end, I almost get just a hint about a little bit of chocolatiness. And I think smoke can do that. Smoke can sort of imitate a chocolate character. Really nice whiskey. I actually had my, you think about something, what you're in the mood for, and so you get your taste up for it. I was actually really in the mood for something that was going to be similar to an Islay whiskey. I'm not saying I'm disappointed. I had expectations. It's really, really nice. It's got the richness and sort of sweetness of a lot of Spey, whiskeys with just the most minuscule amount of smoke put in. I like it. I'm going to give it 88 points. It's not my favorite Japanese whiskey. I think thus far, of all the ones I've tried, I like the Hibiki. That's probably my favorite Japanese whiskey. But this is still really, really, really nice. It's not inexpensive. This is like 80 bucks. Alrighty, that's about it for this review. If you subscribe to this channel, I want to thank you very much. If you haven't yet subscribed, but you like watching my videos, I would greatly appreciate it if you subscribe. If you've tried the Hakushu 12-year-old, I'd like to hear what you think. Put in a comment section down below. And I've uploaded the notes on Japanese whiskey on the Eric Waite Taste Facebook group. So if you're interested in following along in either this study or all my other studies, and you have a Facebook account, you want to check that out, and you can join. And if you go to the file section on the side, you can download notes. All right, that's about it. Until next time, cheers.
Still my guitar.